I want to talk to you tonight about communism. And I have to tell you, I know how many people in America feel when somebody gets on TV and says, I got to talk to you about the communist. 3 years ago, I mean, I would have made fun of people like me. I would have mocked me. I would have. Don't fall into that trap, please, tonight. Open your mind. Open your ears. The country is in trouble. I don't want to believe many of the things that I believe. I think you're the same. But there are communists, believe it or not, communists. It's amazing. I thought we beat it. The best thing to ever happen to the communists was the Red Scare and Joseph McCarthy. We had beat communism. We soundly discredited it. Okay, that's what I thought when the wall came down. Joseph McCarthy, he was a joke, right? In every sense, people viewed communists in his day as traitors who wanted to destroy America. They crept into the unions, especially the teacher unions, that coupled with the colleges. Now you have a situation where communists were starting to be the ones writing and teaching our history. Now what happens? After communism fell, it was erased. We have children growing up now that don't even know what communism is. Now you have the discrediting of Joseph McCarthy. The question is, was Joseph McCarthy right? Was he right? But remember the time period that we're talking about. We're talking at the height of the Cold War. That's when William Ayers is into Marxism. That's when all of the people who are ruling now are into Marxism. Marxism wasn't cool then. Marxism isn't like it is now. If you were a Marxist then, you were a Soviet sympathizer. You were a traitor to our country. You've got to put that into perspective. It's not the same then as it is now. Here is Barack Obama's mentor, Frank Marshall Davis. He has an FBI file on his communist activities. We have the Venona papers were released in the 1980s. What did these say? In 1995 this was released. What did these papers say? Well, remember, the KGB was compiling here. They say that everything that basically this man said was right. They were happening. There were communists everywhere. And they affected everything. I'm sorry, they didn't affect. They infected absolutely everything. Here, in 2000, we have Giselle with her underpants and her swimsuit of Che. We have this Marxist. Here is a very important time. Here's Michael Moore coming into the party, into the Democratic Party, sitting in the presidential box in 2004 with Jimmy Carter. That is critical that you remember that. The infiltration, the final step, come out on the stage and sit next to the president. There's a ton that you need to know. That's how we got here. But is it who we are? Is this who we want to be? Will we even recognize that these people had an influence on it? What these people wanted to do is not a joke. Have they failed? I want you to be the judge. I want you to... You tell me if they failed. Communist goals of 1963 from the Communist Party USA. Just a few of them. Develop the illusion that disarmament of the U.S. would be a demonstration of moral strength. Isn't that what we're doing right now with our nuclear weapons? Number 15, capture one or both of the political parties. Isn't that what Michael Moore did in the presidential box? Get control of the schools and use them as transition belts for socialism and communist propaganda. Number 18, gain control of all student newspapers. 19, use student riots to foment public protest against programs which are under communist attack. Have you been watching this show? Number 20, infiltrate the press. Get control of book review assignments. Oh, you should see the reviews on my books. Editorial writing, policy making decisions. 21, gain control of key positions in radio, TV, and movies. 27, infiltrate the churches and replace revealed religion with social religion. 1963 communist goals. Revealed religion replaced with social religion. 28, no prayer in schools because it violates separation of church and state. Do you know that in New Haven, they just took out in their diplomas the year of our Lord? They just did it because it's offensive. 29, discredit the Constitution by calling it inadequate, old-fashioned, a hindrance to cooperation between nations on a worldwide basis. That's about to happen, that last part. Number 30, discredit the American founding fathers. Please, what are we doing on this show? Trying to restore them. 36, infiltrate and gain control of more unions. 37, infiltrate and gain control of big businesses. What do you think the Tides Foundation is? Number 40, discredit the family as an institution. Encourage promiscuity and easy divorce. Let me ask you a question. These are the goals from 1963. This is 1791. Which one? Which one, America? It's a charter of negative liberties, says our president. Which one? You must choose. Where was the turning point? I believe America's turning point was Joseph McCarthy. And again, with the Berlin Wall falling down. Joseph McCarthy was so discredited, it made it almost into a joke. And when the Berlin Wall fell down, we beat it. And so now we disregarded it. Well, here we go again, down the same road. I want to bring in M. Stanton Evans. He is the author of Blacklisted by History, The Untold Story of Senator Joe McCarthy. Tell me, America, this is such an important turning point. Tell me, when you went to go look for the documents on Joseph McCarthy, what did you find or not find?
I found a lot of stuff missing, a lot of stuff that had been censored, a lot of stuff that was in the records in one place, but blacked out in another place. Mostly what I found was that the FBI files, which backed up what McCarthy was saying, had been withheld for 50 years. And we now have them, or many of them, and they show essentially that he was right in general. There was a massive penetration of the government, and that it was covered up, and that he threatened that cover-up. And that's why he was isolated, demonized, and destroyed. Right. That's the technique.
Okay. Tell me about Dyes, because he was a Democrat.
He was the precursor of McCarthy in the sense that he investigated the same things. He was doing it at a time. He was a Democrat. He was the chairman of a committee. He was doing it at a time, mostly in World War II, when the Soviet Union was our ally. Mm-hmm. And so a lot of people just didn't pay any attention to him. I mean, I had those hearings. They're very fine hearings. But a lot of the information that McCarthy later had, Dyes did not have. He did not have direct access to the FBI stuff. I'm not sure McCarthy did either, but McCarthy had more stuff coming into him.
And McCarthy was, I mean, he was just an imperfect vessel, or was he not? Was he clean? Was he just completely...
He was imperfect, as we all are.
Yeah, yeah.
He made his mistakes, but he was telling the truth.
Okay.
And the truth was huge. It was so huge. We turned out the big lie, Hitler, and so there's also a big truth, a truth so big that people can't believe it.
Right.
And that's kind of what you're saying.
That's why I didn't want to read this, because it changes your focus. And nobody wants to, I mean, gosh, nobody wants to believe that there were people in our government that were bad. You can believe in individuals, but you can't believe this mass kind of, this cover-up.
There were hundreds of them.
You showed me a document. Can you bring this again?
Yeah.
Tell me what this document is. This,
well,
America, will horrify you.
This is, what this is, Glenn, is a record of the so-called Yalta Conference. This is long before McCarthy came along. This is 1945, where Churchill and Roosevelt met with Stalin at Yalta, which is a resort on the Black Sea in the Crimea. And this is the transcript of minutes of what happened at that meeting. An official version of this was published, but the paragraph that I'm going to, maybe I'll give it to you to read, is about Roosevelt is saying to Stalin and Churchill that he is going to meet with the King of Saudi Arabia after this conference, King Saud. And Stalin asked him, does he intend to make any concessions to King Saud of Saudi Arabia? And I'll let you read what the answer is, where the arrow is.
The president replied that there was only one concession he thought he might offer, and that was to give him the 6 million Jews in the United States.
Yes, that is...
This is a collection. Where is this from?
That is from the papers of Edward Stettinius, who is the Secretary of State at the time of Yalta. Those papers are at the University of Virginia in Charlottesville.